Aló, 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 aló.
Cazosas, los.
Aló, 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 aló.
Cazosas, los.
Aló, 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 aló.
Cazosas, los.
Aló, 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 aló.
Keine Zeit, keine Zeit.
Macht euch schon mal hübsch, Mädels, ihr könnt gleich Auto waschen. Macht euch schon mal hübsch, Mädels, ihr könnt gleich Auto waschen.
Hallo, Alter.
So ein Scheiß, beim Roten Netto haben die den Newton-Grillkäse noch ja nicht.
Na denn.
Na dann zum Wohnen, Männers.
So ein Scheiß, beim Roten Netto haben die den Newton-Grillkäse noch ja nicht.
Das ist ja der, was ich immer sage.
Na Louis, Alter.
So ein Scheiß, beim Roten Netto haben die den Newton-Grillkäse noch ja nicht.
Na Louis, Alter. Na Louis, Alter.
Na Louis, Alter. Macht euch schon mal hübsch, Mädels, ihr könnt gleich Auto waschen.
Maul, Alter.
Das ist ja das, was ich immer sage.
Na Louis, Alter.
Na Louis, Alter.
Macht euch schon mal hübsch, Mädels, ihr könnt gleich Auto waschen.
Ey, na komm, dir bezahle ich nochmal ein Taxi. Ich glaube, ich weiß nicht mehr, was ich gelesen habe. Das ist ja mal voll scheiße, oder? Also, es war ein schöner Abend und ich musste mich gerne mal mit euch verabschieden, aber ich bin nicht als erstes nach Hause gelaufen. Das ist nicht wahr.
Ja, denn.
Na dann zum Wohnen, Männers.
Hallo, 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 hallo.
Was ist los?
Hallo, 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 hallo.
Na Louis, Alter.
Hallo, 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 hallo.
Maul, Alter.
Hallo, 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 hallo.
Keine Zeit, keine Zeit.
Das ist ja das, was ich immer sage. Das ist ja das, was ich immer sage.
Macht euch schon mal hübsch, Mädels, ihr könnt gleich Auto waschen.
Keine Zeit.
Macht euch schon mal hübsch, Mädels, ihr könnt gleich Auto waschen. Macht euch schon mal hübsch, Mädels, ihr könnt gleich Auto waschen.
Hallo, 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 hallo.
Macht
Maul, Alter.
Hallo, 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 hallo.
Macht waschen, waschen.
Hallo, 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 hallo.
So ein Scheiß, beim Roten Netto haben die den Newton-Grillkäse noch ja nicht. So ein Scheiß, beim Roten Netto haben die den Newton-Grillkäse noch ja nicht.
Mach Maul, Alter!
Na denn?
Thank you.
Hello. Hello. Hello, and welcome to Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. My name is Brendan. This is my show. How's it going out there? I switched my cameras back to the way they were before. I still do have the desk cam that is there. Just using the other camera. I just thought it was too weird. It was like really blurry. I didn't like it. So we're going with this instead. Yeah, what's new? What's going on? What's up? The plan for today is I want to work on some dialogue exercises. I've been struggling a lot with dialogue in my personal projects, and I think I need to really improve on that. So yeah, I want to work on dialogue. Do that kind of thing. See if maybe I can start getting a better idea of what I need to do to get things going, you know? So yeah. Check something real quick here. Hey, what's going on? All right. Here we go. I do think it's funny how much glare my glasses get, though. That's weird. Okay, so this is a dialogue exercise from Holly... I'm going to pronounce this wrong. I always do. Holly Lil... Lizzle? I can never pronounce it. It's God. Damn it. There we go. Who's a writer? I know that she's published a ton of books. I mostly know her for her writing classes, which are pretty cool. But yeah. Being a fan of what she does, she has some writing exercises on her blog on her website, so I thought I would start with that and work our way from there. So I took a few moments before we got started to prep the exercises and all that, so we would be good to go when we got started, which will be very short. Okay. So, we'll start off with a scenario. A man and a woman who have been married for 15 years meet on the sidewalk in their front yard as she is coming home and he is on his way out. The day is gray and blustery, with the smell of snow in the air and rapidly falling temperatures. She is dressed far too lightly for the weather. She was supposed to be home all day. He wasn't supposed to be home at all. One of them has to tell the other something important. The other one has to keep the first from finding out something important. Then, to the assignment. Exercise 1. Sit with your eyes closed until you can see these two people standing in front of their house. See where they're standing in relation to each other, near or far. How they hold their bodies. The expressions on their faces when they surprise each other on the walk. Remember that one of them has something to hide and the other has something to tell. You have to know what these two things are before you begin. The two things can be anything you like. Remember that one is going to avoid telling the truth for whatever reason, and may be benign or malignant, and the other may have a hard time saying what he or she has to say. When you can see them, and when you can hear their voices, write for 10 minutes. Do not use any words outside of quotes at all. This includes even he said or she said. Just let their voices come through. Write the words as they say them. Don't correct the grammar for them or go back to change anything you have written. Don't cross out anything. Don't erase anything. Just let it all ride and force them to deal with the consequences. Do not allow them to call each other by name. So those are our parameters. So think about your character. Starting to get a bit of a vibe. So, I do know that I want to avoid anything about adultery because I just don't care about it. It's also really done. Maybe a conversation about work. That could work. What other options do I have here? I'd probably prefer to avoid divorce talk as well. Take a sheet here and write down what I think to tell. Hmm. go back to our scenario real quick there, just so I can see it. Boom. And go with this. Okay, got it. I've got it. Let's do this. Thank you. for 15 minutes instead of 10. But that's fine. It's all good. Got the point across. So then what comes next? You finish, sit back for a few minutes and cool off, then read what you read. Catching up on my on the exercise here. Bum, bum, bum. Exercise 2. Okay, I'm gonna print out my dialogue and then we're gonna look. At what it means. So I'm gonna turn off my mic for a sec because my printer's loud. Be quick. All right, we're back. That was weird. Holly makes a good point where she talks about the tones and the moods will flow very fast, and I think that's very true of what I've been doing here. Let's try some stuff out. Let's go. I've been wanting to play around with this a bit, so let's do it. Zoom in a bit here. Page. Oh, that ought to focus. I'm gonna turn that off. I want to focus there. That's better. So, when I was writing this, I kind of cheated in the fact that I actually did the same to tell and to hide. And I don't know if this was intended or not, but I kind of felt like their psychology changed from to tell and to hide, like, every few lines. Where they kind of like flip-flopped in their goal of what they wanted. I don't think that's a question mark. That's a period. I think I'm going to take an early break and then I'll come back and do exercise 2. Flush this out. This is weird. I don't hate it, but it's strange. It's like a 3-something came up in a row. This will be Ive. This intention isn't really clear. That's not how you spell anything. Intention. I think he'd be on, I think he would have claimed it was like a business trip or something. Depends on what his previous job was, I suppose. She just says oh a lot, really. He's mad. She doesn't care. Should be a comma here. And, I feel like this should be a little less vague. Here. I think this is like a he starts walking away. This makes no sense. I'd like to rewrite this piece right here. Question mark. Close down doesn't make sense. It would be more like folded or bankrupted or something. Now she's pissed at the company, not him. Should be a pause here, I think. Sarcasm. Should be like a trail off. is, but he broke. And with emphasis. This is a. I feel like the conversation jumps right here. So that's kind of weird. Good. All right, I'm gonna take a break. Generally, I take a 10-minute break, but I think I'm just gonna take a 13-minute break. I'll be back at 1 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. And I will do part two of this exercise. Actually, I'll go over that real quick before I go. So in exercise two, so exercise one, you wrote classic talking heads. You know, something you're supposed to avoid in general. It was a first draft though. So exercise two, you're gonna go back and take that dialogue and fill in and add all the stuff to make it like a scene. You know, which is why I added all those notes on the page there, of like kind of what thoughts I had and what things I can improve on. So there's that. Then there's an exercise three, but I might not do it. Exercise three is just try something with external conflict or like more characters or stuff like that. So yeah, that is an option. But I did find some other stuff as well. So we might do one of those other things and see what we can come up with. But I am going to be doing dialogue all day today. So yeah, work on exercise. Improve the things we're weak at, as it were. So yeah, I'm going to take a break. I'll be back at 1 o'clock. It's about 11 minutes now. So that's perfect. I'll see you all then.
europäischen Kontinent, ja vielleicht in der ganzen Welt, ist in unmittelbarer Gefahr. Wenn es zerreißt, sind die Folgen unabsehbar. Wenn Feindseligkeiten ausbrechen sollten, werden das Leben von Millionen von Männern, Frauen und Kindern in jedem betroffenen Lande beinahe mit Gewissheit unter unaussprechlichen Sorgen zerstört werden.
We'll be right back.
let's expand this out. What should our characters' names be? It's come along nicely. Copy this and move it down. There we Ooh. Oh. Damn. No, it wouldn't be morality. It would be her integrity. I don't think these should be questions. I think these should be periods. Thank you. You be. Words, eh? Interesting. Yeah, it really, really is. So yeah, yet again, during another one of my streams, there's a snowstorm going on. This happens a lot. I really want to take a break, but I'm very close to done. So I think I'm just going to push through, get this done, then take my break. I think if I'm not mistaken... Okay, yeah, no, this is going to take too long. I'm going to take my break, and then I will be back, and I will finish this up. And looking at the time, I'm not entirely sure I'm going to get to something else, so maybe not. Like another dialogue exercise. What I might do is... I don't know. I'll come up with something. But yeah, I'm going to take a 10-minute break, so I'll be back at around 2:05 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Whatever the time zone is right now, I don't know. It's all good. See you all in a bit. All right, I'm back. So I'm going to finish this up, and then I think I'm going to call it a day for the stream. But I will be back tomorrow. For the entire month of February, I will be streaming on Sundays and Mondays. Thank you. this up too. Thank you. I'm pretty happy with that. That's pretty good. 1,200 words. Wow. I'm actually rather happy with that output. So I'm just going to talk about a couple things to do with this real quick, and then I'm going to go for the day. Just to A, eat up some time, and B, because I made some conclusions when I was doing these exercises. I think, and this is something I've been talking about with some of my friends in real life and all that, about writing. But I consider myself to be someone who's better at scripting than prose. I fit that mindset better. I've spent more time doing it, I guess. I don't know if that's entirely true, but it feels like it. You'll notice that a lot of the stuff that I've completed on stream have been scripts. You know, I've done two comic scripts. I've done a short film. To a certain extent, a game script. That was more of a prototype. Whether it's finished or not, who knows, but was kind of there. That being Zix, not... what was that one? The other one I did that I can't remember the name of. Which is really sad. Yeah. So I consider myself to be better at scripting. So the one thing I've noticed is that I have no... When I'm writing my own prose projects, it takes me a long time to get little bits done. And I don't know if that's because I know I have a plan and I know what direction I'm going in, or if it's because I'm just not good at doing sequential. But what I'm finding right now is that it makes a lot more sense for me to sort of lay out the pieces, lay out my breadcrumbs, and then start fleshing it out. That kind of process is very similar to what I do when I'm scripting, right? Where, you know, I kind of figure out, oh, I think this will be about four panels, or this action will be one or two panels, and then this will be one or two, and then I kind of figure it out, right? When I put out this dialogue, like, the dialogue kind of came bit by bit, but when I wanted to get into the actual story parts, it was like this. Like, I could kind of just do it. And feel free to weigh in on what I'm thinking here. But I've noticed that a lot of the exercises I do, I have no problem, like, throwing down 1,000 words, whatever. Whereas in my own personal projects, 1,000 words can take a lot longer to do. If you ever heard me talk about my short story Dinner, I mean, I've been working on that thing since last February. Done 23 drafts of it. And it's still not done. It's still not close to done. I have to rewrite most of it still. And maybe that's just the nature of that story and the conclusions I had to come to from an author's perspective to get that done. But it is a long, long time. And I mean, that's not the only thing I've worked on since last February or anything like that. I have worked on some other things here and there. So it's not like that's my entire creative output for the year was this unfinished piece or something like that. And also, to be fair, that is the first real short story I've ever worked on. I've done a lot of, like, flash fiction stuff, like 1,000-word pieces or short pieces and prompts for, like, creative writing classes and, like, things like that. But I've never really done something that's, like, this is a solid short story. I've done short films, of course, and stuff like that. So there's definitely that element to it, where, like, in a lot of ways, this was me learning how to write a short story in the first place, because I've never really done it before. So that's another part of the whole process of it, right? So yeah, I don't know. I am thinking that one of the things that's helped me a lot is the TK method. I posted a few I'm not sure which episode. I posted it on one of the episodes where I was talking about it. I'll repost it on this episode, I think. But there was an article I read not too long ago about this thing called TK. Well, it was in a drafting blog about writing. And there's this thing called TK, and what it means is it's kind of like a shorthand that reporters use when they need to fact-check something. So instead of spending time fact-checking or spending time thinking, you just put TK and you move on. Like a capital T, capital K. Because I'm pretty sure there's no word in the English language that actually uses those together in that order. So yeah, it'll always stand out. So when you're getting to, like, when you're working on edits and all that, you can be like, oh, hey, like, I need to fill in this section, I need to fill in this section, and just keep drafting as you go. That sort of thing. And that's really helped my mindset of, like, just putting words on the page. And it's interesting to me because in a lot of ways, that process is exactly what I'm talking about right now, where I'm saying, like, it's like filling in what you know and then coming back to what you don't know. So, you know, having your characters have a conversation about conflict and all that stuff, and like just fill in those words, and then you can add the actions and all the thoughts and emotions around them afterwards. And I'm definitely thinking that I need to go back. There's a couple of spots in Dinner that really feel like talking heads to me, or one of my friends described it as sock puppets, which is a great analogy for what that is. Where, you know, I have some talking sock puppets just like mouthing off at each other. And maybe what I should do is I should sit down and be like, let's just write the dialogue for that scene. Like, what are they saying? And then take that and merge it with my previous draft and be like, okay, so what are they saying? How can I give them more character? And then add in all the science-y details that come with that. So that's a thought I had. As well as, I think what I want to do is I want to take a look at some more processes. Some more of other people's processes. The interesting thing about being a writer is that there's no right answer. There's no one thing that you can do that really puts it all together. You know, everyone does it differently. But, so what I'm saying is it doesn't really work to copy other people's processes. But you can use other people's processes to inform your own process. You can pick up little bits here and there. Like, I picked up that TK thing, and I can pick up this other thing. And they'll just help you build your whole idea of how you work on a project. And I think processes need to be reevaluated on a fairly regular basis, at least once a year, probably more than that. You don't want to spend a ton of time, like, thinking about how to write rather than just writing, but you should be, like, look at ways that you can improve your process, you can streamline your process so that it's easier for you to do what you want to do. I guess what I mean by that is that it's easy to get caught up in a way that you think works when there might be an easier way to do that. But you don't want to get so caught up thinking about that easier way that you don't just do the way that actually works, whether it's harder or not. So yeah, I guess writing's always been kind of that conundrum of you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't, as it were. So yeah, those are my thoughts for today. About 2:30. Yeah, I think that's about it for me. I will be back tomorrow at 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time doing more streaming. I suspect I'll be doing more dialogue exercises because I definitely think that's something I need to improve on. So there's certainly that. don't think I have anything else. I'm pretty happy with the way this has went. I do wish that it was not so prompty and that I could edit this into an actual piece that I could use somewhere. But, you know, them's the breaks. Not every piece of writing you do has to be published worthy. And that's something I've been learning a lot from my artist friends of, you know, John the Studio said the other day that he doesn't trust an artist who doesn't doodle. And a bunch of people talking about how, you know, you're going to have bad drawings. If you don't have bad drawings, you're never going to make good drawings. So I think in a lot of ways, writers need to get out of this. And maybe this is just me, and maybe I'm doing writers a disservice by lumping them in with my thought process here, but you need to get out of that mindset of everything you do has to be publishable. Everything you do has to be the greatest thing you've ever written. I think you got to do a lot of bad writing in order to get to the stuff that's really good. And that's not to say just like your first draft will be bad, but you know, like, there's no reason for me to do anything with this. There's no reason for me to really, rework, certain things that I've written on stream. As cool as ideas they are, and we come up with lots of cool ideas, I think, you know, you gotta do all that stuff in order to get to the stuff that really matters, I guess, is a good way of putting it. So yeah. As always, you can check me out on Twitter or on my website directly over there. I got the points right today. Yeah, learning. Where you can find VODs and ask me questions and have my contact info, as well as there's always additional episode resources for each episode, like articles I looked at. I'm going to be posting the blog for Holly Lizzle. I don't know. I can't pronounce it. Her blog post that I used to do this exercise, as well as some other stuff I was looking at. And that TK thing. I'll repost that. So, yeah. Without further ado, my name is Brendan. This is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. I will see you all tomorrow. Have a good one, guys.